Hi, it's Jannie. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be sharing with you some of my favorite items. These are products that I've been using or even some lifestyle favorites that I'm going to share with you. So if you're interested and want to know what I'm liking, then just keep on watching. Okay, the first thing I'm going to talk about is, I think I'm going to talk about something that I haven't mentioned in my channel. Or on my channel, not necessarily in my channel, on my channel, but maybe once or twice in the whole time that I've been on YouTube. And that is a sunscreen. And the reason why I've never really mentioned a sunscreen is because I had never used a sunscreen on my face. And whenever I would try to use a sunscreen on my face, I did not like it. It would make me feel like I was being suffocated because it would leave just like a layer on the skin and it wouldn't absorb. It would leave a white cast and I just didn't like it. It would sting my eyes if I happened to get it into my eyes. So I was like, I'm just not going to use one. Well, in my Korean beauty escapades the last several months, well, since November, I've been ordering a lot of K-Beauty, I came across this sunscreen here, and what it is from Misha, and it's the All Around Safe Block Essence Sun Milk. It's 50 SPF 50+ PA++++. I did order mine off of SokoGlam, and I have really been liking this. I mean, I've been using it every single day. I'm probably about halfway finished with this product, and once this is an empty, that will be the first sunscreen that I have ever completely used all the way from start to finish. I mean, I've tried all kinds of sunscreens before and we use them for a while, but then I don't like it. I don't like the way it feels. I don't like the way I feel like I can't breathe. I don't like it. You know, I don't like it. I don't know how many times I can say that, but I just have never liked a sunscreen. Not on my body, not on my face. And I know it's very, very important, you know, to protect the skin from the elements and the UVA and the UVB rays out there in the sun, even on cloudy days. Even if I'm just going to be going from my house into my car to work, in my car and back, I'm still being exposed. So when I seen this on SokoGlam, it had really good reviews. I was watching, I think her name is Joan Kim, and she talked about it. So I thought, well, I'm going to order it and give it a try. And I'm so glad that I did, because it's a very lightweight. It's not greasy. It doesn't leave a white cast. It doesn't make me feel like I'm suffocating. Plus, it has skincare benefits in it, other than protecting the skin. And yeah, so, and the makeup goes on very nice. It looks like that there, but it rubs around onto the skin and absorbs into the skin just like that. I mean, I hardly rubbed it around at all. It's already absorbed into the skin. It leaves a really pretty finish on the face, and I'm in love. And the only thing that I don't like about it is when you look at this product on the website, the bottle appears to be about this big, is what it looks like, but it's not. It's only about this big. It's not very big at all. It's 40 mil is how much it is. And let's see, in comparison to my Prep and Prime, it looks like that. So that's the only thing I don't like, is that it's a small bottle. I want it in a big bottle, so I have it. Anyway, so I have definitely found a sunscreen that I like. I like it a lot. I was using the one from Shiseido that a lot of people talk about, and I did like that. I liked that better than I had liked any other sunscreen before, but I like this better. So anyway, so I have that. Okay, another skincare product that I have is again from K-Beauty, Korean Beauty, and it's this little guy here. I ordered this back in November, I do believe, from Wish Trend, and this is the I'm From Magnolia Wake Essence, and it does it is marketed as an essence, but I use it as a serum because it's a little bit thicker in consistency, like a gel type consistency that I associate more with a serum than I do a essence. And let's see if I can, if you will be able to see. Wait. So it's a little bit thicker than what your normal essence would be. It's very hydrating. It absorbs into the skin. It has the magnolia extract in it. I think it has, 69% of magnolia water in it. Oh my gosh, and the smell. If you don't like anything that has a floral scent to it, you're not going to like this. But me personally, the scent of the magnolia is my favorite. One of my favorite scents of all time. I just think it smells so good. So every morning when I put this on, I use this as my morning serum. It smells so good. I just want to put it everywhere, but it's very hydrating. It absorbs very quickly into the skin. It's not sticky. It doesn't leave a tacky feel, and it just feels so good and just so pretty and smells so good. And the packaging, I mean, gotta love this packaging. It's just so pretty and feminine and delicate looking. It is a glass bottle, so I have definitely been enjoying this essence, and like I said, I use it as a serum. Okay, the next item I want to talk about is a hair product. Now, I've had someone comment that they felt like my hair was looking really, really good here lately, so thank you very much. And I am going to say it's because of this product here. This product right here. This is the Eva Night. It's not the Eva Night. I always think that that C is an E. It's not. It's the Eva NYC Therapy Session Hair Mask. You can get this at Ulta for around $15. And of course, they're all the time. You're running sales. You can use your coupon on it. And the way that I use this is... Okay, first of all, let me tell you a little bit how I cleanse my hair. I only shampoo my hair twice a week. I don't do it more than that. There's no need for me to do it more than that. My hair is naturally dry and coarse. And so the more oil I have in my hair, the better it looks. It may sound gross to some people that have really oily hair and don't like the oil look, but my hair craves hydration, regardless of however way it can get it, by me producing my own oil or adding moisture products to it. Anyway, so what I use, this, how I use it is I don't use it as a hair mask in addition to a conditioner. I use this strictly for my conditioner. So I will shampoo my hair and then I will go straight to this product here. I'll wring out all the moisture in my hair and then I'll put this on, and then I will get out of the shower and I'm going to show you what this looks like. It's just a little cream, and the smell of it is so good. Oh my gosh, it's so good. Anyway, I will get out of the shower and I will, because I've gotten the water I can out of it, I put that on there, and then I'll put a little plastic bag on my head. And then I will set my timer. I keep my little kitchen timer in my bathroom. I don't know, fun fact about me, you may not know, but I don't cook. I probably cook maybe 12 times a year, maybe. I don't cook, so I don't need this timer in my kitchen. I don't need it in my kitchen. So I put it in my bathroom, and I set it for 15 minutes. And I'll stay in my bathroom for like 15 minutes. I don't have the shower running because, you know, that I want to conserve water. Because you never know, even though Oklahoma is not in a drought like other parts of the country, you never know. It could happen. So I want to make sure I'm conserving water whenever I can. So I turn my water off and I get out of my shower and I'll put this on, and I will either clean my bathroom or I'll put a mask on my face while I'm sitting out there for 15 minutes, or I'll look at my iPad and look at videos or something like that. But yeah, I stay in the bathroom because I'm dripping wet from my shower. I don't dry off because I'm trying really hard to lessen my use of a towel. That's another tip from the Korean beauty channels that I've been watching is to, first of all, not use a towel on your face or a washcloth. So I have quit doing that. So that could be something else that may be contributing to my skin looking better, is I don't use a washcloth to wash my face. I strictly use my hands, and I don't use a towel to dry my face. I let it dry naturally. So anyway, my body, I'm still using a towel, but I'm really working hard on pat and dry and not rubbing. So anyway, we're totally off topic here. We're talking about my hair. Anyway, this will make your hair very shiny and soft and manageable, and it just looks really good. I think it does. I think it's helped my curls. My hair, okay, first of all, you guys have heard me say this lots of time. My hair is its own person. My hair controls the rest of me. Yeah. I don't tell my hair what to do. It tells me what to do. It's like, hey. So anyway, my curls like it. My curls, it's curls approved. Yeah, so I do like that. So if you haven't tried it, check it out. And I will tell you, I've had this in my collection for a while. Someone had shown it in one of their videos and raved about it, so I went and got it. I used it once. I didn't like it. So I put it in my little tub over there, and this year I didn't do a Project Pam, but I decided I was going to really work on eliminating and going through and using up my backup hair care products that I have, either by donating them, using them, or tossing them. And this was one of the ones that I pulled out. I'm like, I was going to give it away. I was going to give it to my daughter. And I thought, no, I'm going to try it first and make sure I don't really like it before I give it to her. She ain't getting it. No, she's not getting that. I like it. I like it a lot. And so anyway, I recommend that. So, okay, now the next product that I want to talk about is not really a product, as it is a technique. And darn it, I didn't bring a highlighter. Hang on. I'm back. Okay. So the next product I want to talk about is really not a product, but a technique. And I was watching, I don't remember what video it was, but apparently she had learned it from watching Jaclyn Hill. I don't watch Jaclyn Hill, so. But anyway, she was did it in a Get Ready. And I had been noticing in her videos, you know, how glowy her skin was looking. And not artificial glow, but like just a really natural, really pretty beaming type glow. I'm thinking, man, I wonder how she was doing that. And she did a video on how she got her glow. And she taught me this trick. She taught me this, not Jaclyn Hill. Jaclyn Hill didn't teach me anything. So anyway. So you just whatever highlighter you're using in the day for that morning's makeup routine, any highlighter, doesn't matter. Any highlighter you want to use. So this just happens to be one from Jouer that was in my Beautylush Lucky Bag. And I would tell you the color of it, but I can't read it. I can't read it. Hang on, let me get my glasses. I am not prepared. Oh, and I got new glasses too. Hey, this will be a chance for you to see my glasses. I wear glasses. There's... it felt like there was something in my shirt moving around. microphone, it's the cord. I'm pulling it. I thought, what is in my shirt that's moving around? I sat there for a minute, my sugar gliders were in there, because, oh my God, I'm going nuts. Okay, back to the glasses. I do wear glasses all the time, except for when I'm filming videos, because there's a glare right there. But I had to get some new ones, so this is what I got. I'll try to turn a little bit where you're not getting too much of a glare. How's that? So anyway, I like them. Trying to get used to them because my bifocal, and I have the no-line bifocals because I'm a little vain like that. Anyway, I went from like a 1.25 to 2.25, so a full strength up, and it's taking a little time to get used to. Plus, I had to get like a bigger circumference right here because the ones I had wasn't giving me enough bifocal. So anyway, so I got a little bit bigger ones. Anyway, okay, so this bronzer is the rose gold. I should have known that by looking at it. But anyway, okay, let's take those off. So, what was that? Something just blew up my nose. Man, this is... Okay, and you can use any kind of sponge that you want to. You can use a beauty blender, whatever you want. I personally like these little sponges that I get from Ulta. It's the Real Techniques, the Four Miracle Contour Wedges is what I like. So, and you can either wet it with water, wet your sponge with water, or you can use some kind of spray. I right now I'm using this MAC Fix Plus just because I have it, and it's one of those products that I really probably need to use before it goes bad. So you're just going to spray your sponge and then just put it into your highlighter, and then just put it onto your cheeks and where you put a highlight down the nose. And look, I mean, look how pretty that is. Can you see that? Can you see it? Look how pretty. And it doesn't look, you know, like I'm trying to be 20 years old. No, it just looks like I have really pretty glowy skin, which is what I want people to think that I have. I don't want them to think that I'm trying to be J-Lo when I'm not. So put a little bit on my nose and a little bit up here and a little bit there. So there. So yeah. Isn't that pretty? I have been loving it. And I was actually, before I washed that, I was kind of struggling with my highlight. I had been using one brush for a very long time with my highlight, and I was really liking it. And it's like anything else. You know how you have an outfit that you've worn 10 times and you love it, and then one day you get up and you go to wear it and you hate it. You don't like the way it looks on you anymore. Well, that's kind of how I was feeling with my highlight. I just wasn't liking the way it was going on. It didn't matter what I used. And so I'm glad I watched that video and found that technique. So there you go. So that's the technique I want to share. Okay, the last thing I'm going to share with you is a show that I've been watching, or that I watched, I finished it already, on Netflix, and it's called The Fall. And it is a crime drama. It's on Netflix. I think I said that. There's like three seasons. It's like a series. So basically the whole three seasons, the whole series is about this crime detective. It all takes place in Belfast, Ireland, first of all. So beautiful scenery, and I love the way that they all speak. It has Gillian Anderson in it. Love her. She was on The X-Files, if you know The X-Files, you know, the main character in The X-Files. And it also has Jamie Dornan, which is from the Shades of Grey movies, the 50 Shades of Grey, has him in there. He is a serial killer, and she is a homicide detective. They call it something different, but anyway, you get the gist. And the whole series, the whole three-season series, is about her trying to catch him and the process that she goes through on trying to catch him. It also shows you it from his point of view. You know, you get into his life and how he thinks and what has driven him to kill, and you know how he manipulates and hurts other people that he has into his life. He lives a completely different lifestyle. His character is not one that you would suspect being a serial killer. So it's really good. I really did enjoy it, and I thought that it was, the storyline was really good, and I thought that the two actors there really portrayed their characters very well. I enjoyed it. Some people have said it's kind of slow. I didn't feel that way. I could have watched it another season. And to be honest with you, I didn't really like the way that it ended. I didn't want it to end that way. I kind of wanted it to end a different way so that the series could keep going. But anyway, that was the fall. Right now I'm watching The Killing, but I just started it, so I don't know if I can recommend it or not. But anyway, so that is it, my friends, for this week's favorites. Geez, I talked a lot today. I've had a lot of Diet Coke, as you can tell. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button right there. And also click on that little bell icon notification so that you're notified of all future videos. And I will be talking to you soon. Bye.